My guest today is Atley Hunter. Atley, how are you?
Hey, good, good. How are you doing, Dave?
I'm doing terrific. I'm enjoying my stay in Canada.
Well, yeah, Canada's always happy to have you here.
Oh, excellent. Tell me, because you haven't been on my show in like 5 years.
It's been a while.
It's been a long time. Tell me what you do. What are you doing these days?
Well, I still I write mobile apps. Write mobile apps and deal with my customer base. Lots of Windows Phone users out there. I've got lots of my stuff, and we take
care still
of them.
Focusing on Windows Phone.
Yep. Yeah, I find that return on investment has been very high for us on those. We have hundreds of thousands of users active every month, and we enjoy it. And they seem to be really appreciating the work that we're doing, and my wife and I are doing, and it's been good for us. It's been very good to us.
All right, but the you're also doing a lot of Xamarin stuff as well. So we're ready for Android, ready for iPhone. Is there a big difference in the apps that you build for each of the platforms?
I don't really. I don't differentiate. Well, I mean, other than the fact that you want to make sure that you're taking into account how the users use the different platforms and making sure that things stay familiar to them and usable and easy to understand, the paradigms and everything
that you're Apple, for example.
Exactly, that you're respecting the way the users use their devices on the different platforms. Other than that, no, the what I'm writing is basically the same.
Let's talk a little bit about the way people use those devices, because you have some strong opinions about a lot. I mean, you're not only a developer of apps, you're an end user of apps as well. And you see problems with some of the apps that people are building, right?
Well, yeah, I think that in the beginning, we started writing apps that were very, very simple. They were, well, simple to use.
Okay.
I find that our job as developers is to take an otherwise complex task or a mundane task and make it inconsequential or delightful to do.
Okay.
Right. So,
great job.
Exactly, and that's the thing is that I've always said that as an app developer, your real job is to make the user smile. If a user smiles, or you know, is happier when they're finished using your app than they were when they started, then your app's successful.
Cool. I hope my viewers are smiling right now.
Hopefully.
That's a simple statement, but that's a big statement. What's make your users smile? How do we do that?
Well, I find that a lot of apps have started to get a little bloated, and they started to get a little more complex and a little more overdrawn, overdone.
Yep.
And you're starting to see developers come back to that whole, how do I tell the users how to use my app? Well, if you have to tell the users how to use your app, chances are your app's too complicated.
Oh, so your app should be intuitive. You should pick it up, and you should know how to use it just by looking at it.
Yes, you should really, like, your UI should describe to the user what's happening, and the user should be able to get through the flow of what they're doing quickly and effectively and easily without having to spend too much time worrying about how they're doing it. They should just think about what they're doing.
All right. Is that the apps that you see that other people are building, the ones in the app stores, do they follow that principle, in your opinion?
Less and less. So there are some apps out there that are fantastic UIs that are very, very interesting and innovative UIs. But sometimes you'll see the slant has been more now to create a wow factor rather than create an easy factor.
So wowness just for the shape of wowness is that wears off. It's cool the first couple of days, but after a while you're like, this is in my way. Get this out of my way.
It ends up being the thing that, you know, someone shows, oh, look, you can do this. But then you find out that you never do that.
Oh, yeah. That's a good principle. We sometimes build for ourselves, right? We think, oh, I love this feature, therefore everyone will love this feature. And that's obviously not always true.
You've got to remember who your user base is. Your user base is very seldom you or people exactly like you. It's usually people that are busy, the device is an appliance, it's a tool for getting things done or to, you know, distract themselves for a while or to do different things. When it comes down to building apps to take care of like utility functions or everyday functions or manage information or things like that, it should be your goal to get it done and get it out of the way.
What about some apps solve problems that are just by their nature complex?
Yes.
Can we simplify those even if we're solving a complex problem?
Well, and that's actually the point is that you're supposed to take complex problems and take the complexity out of them, make it a simple thing to do.
Can you give me an example or some guidance that people that are building apps can go by?
Well, like for example, let's say you've got a finance app. I've got finance apps that are in the store. I also have budgeting apps that are in the store.
Okay, and those are relatively complex things.
And those are both complex things.
I have my credit cards. I have my bank account. I have my budget. I have my automatic check deposit. There's a lot of things that a finance app could do.
No, exactly, exactly. And so what your goal is to make the core functions easy to find.
Okay.
To make the core functions easy to do. And then get out of their way. Like,
how do you do that? Tell me about your finance app. First of all, what's the name of it so people can download it?
I'm not telling you the name of it because it's in one of my picket fenced
accounts. Okay. Oh, yeah, all right. So it's not something. Yeah, later on, you can promote a public app that people could download.
Yeah. Exactly.
But for this one here, how did you make it more simple, more accessible, easy to use?
If you look at some of the apps out there, you'll see that they'll take a complex structure, like let's say you're putting in a receipt.
Okay.
And you put in a receipt and it, you end up creating something that has a ton of line items so that you can add the taxes, you can add this, you can add that, a bunch of different things. But not everybody wants to do that. Some people just want to go, I spent $50.
Yep.
So you give them the option to say, I spent $50. And if they want to add another line, they can add another line.
Okay.
They can put in the tax. They can break it down. They can do whatever they want to do, however they want to do it. So you give them the option to just get in and get out of the way.
Okay.
Or you give them the option to go as deep as they want.
Oh, so configuration would be one way of doing that. Allow them to configure this on the simplest way.
Not really, because then you end up into steps where you've got to go to the settings, you got to change this, you got to change that. So what you do is you develop a UI that basically says, enter what you spent.
Okay.
And then they have the option to add another line to it.
So if
the person wants to, they can just put in $50. But if they want to break it down and say, I spent $32 in this and $6 in this and the tax was $4, and they can add those line items. And at the bottom, it totals it up. And then it adds it all as one entry.
Okay. So I think in this example, you've made the simplest case the default case.
Exactly.
Yeah. And those people that want more complexity, they can
just, and they don't have to go to another page or anything. It's just they can continue adding line items. They can put as much detail in as they want.
Oh, I like that. Okay.
So things like that ends up making for a really, really easy UI.
All right. You were talking yesterday about maybe building two apps that do two different things, rather than building one giant app that does everything.
Yeah. Well, and you'll see that in the same case where you've got finance, some people want a budget app that's very simple, where they just put in, this is how much my rent is, this is how much my gas is, this is how much my insurance is, and they break it down and then they go, this is basically what I make, this is all my major expenses, and this is my rough spending money. And at the end of the month, I put in, I had $300 in spending money this month. I spent $260.
Oh, as opposed to the complexity of saying, I spent $5 on this latte.
Exactly, exactly.
So $7.50 on lunch and so on.
Exactly. So a lot of people don't necessarily want that. But what you can do is you can give them the option to use the account tracking app and then tie the two pieces of data together by making them talk to each other.
Oh, okay.
And then that way the people that want to have the detail can put the detail in. The people that want the general budget can see the general budget. And then you create the complexity in the background to go and get the line items out of their general spending or out of their generic spending and match them up.
Okay. It's the same idea of microservices, I think,
exactly,
right?
Exactly.
It's accepted with a UI element to it. Where
exactly.
A big monolithic system is much more complex than a lot of small systems with clearly defined interfaces.
Exactly, yeah. And that ends up being much more usable for the user. And the users are much happier because they do what they want, how they want, when they want.
Hmm. What else?
I don't know.
Okay. All right, this is really good stuff. And you, I promise I'll let you promote anything you want to promote.
No.
No, you don't want to sell all your apps?
No.
To the general public?
We're actually
How about do you have an online presence?
I do have an online presence, so you can reach me at Atley Hunter on Twitter.
Uh-huh. Well, your name is like upside down and backwards.
Yeah, my name's upside down. And you can reach me on LinkedIn at Atley Hunter. Uh-huh. And I'm available all over the place on Skype at Atley.Hunter.
Atley, thanks so much.
Thanks. Some people use technology to make friends. I use technology to be a friend.